Hi, welcome to the Statics Tutorials. So in the previous video, we had this truss and we wanted to solve for the forces in HG, HC, and BC here. So I drew a free body diagram and we solved for the reactions at EY and AY. So you may want to go back to the previous video and take a look at that if you haven't already seen that one. But in the previous video, we solved for those three forces with method of joints. This video, we're going to take a look at solving for those three unknowns with method of sections. So to create our section, we want to cut completely through the truss and have it so we have two completely separate sides of the truss. We also want to cut through only three unknowns, and in this case, we can cut through the three unknowns that we want to solve for and separate our truss into two pieces all in one shot. Each piece of the truss needs to have at least two pins. If it doesn't have at least two pins or two joints, it's really just a method of joints again. So in this case, we have A, B, and H. So we have three pins, so we have more we have two or more. Here's our section view. So we have pin A here, so we need to include the AY force. We have pin B, so we need to include the 30 kilonewtons. Pins C, D, and E, though, are on that other side, so we're not going to show the 50, the 20, or EY anywhere on this free body diagram, and none of those forces will show up in our sum of forces and sum of moments equations. We cut through HG, so we need to show FHG. We cut through HC, so we need to show the force there, and we cut through BC, so we'll show the force there. And then taking a look at these, you'll see this repeated pin here. So pin HG and pin HC. So H is repeated. So if we do a sum of moments about H, both of these two forces go through H and they're not going to show up in our equation. So a sum of moments about H would give us FBC times that height of 3 meters, and that's a positive moment, minus the 52.5 times the horizontal distance of 4 meters. We can get the FBC then as positive 70 kilonewtons. Since it's positive, when we drew it as if it was in tension, we know that it must be in tension. We can take a look and see that pin C is also repeated. And so we can do a moment about pin C. Note that pin C is not on this free body diagram, but that's perfectly okay. So sum of moments about pin C, we'll have FHG times that y distance of 3 meters, and that'll give us a negative moment. We'll have the 52.5 times the 8-meter distance over to C, and then we'll have the 30 kilonewtons times the 4-meter distance over to C. We'll be able to solve for FHG as our only unknown. We'll get negative 100 kilonewtons. So it must have been 100 kilonewtons in compression since we got a negative number. And then we can do sum of forces in Y. FHC is the only force that has a Y component here, so it'll be our only unknown in this equation. We'll have our 52.5 on this side, negative 30 kilonewtons, and then the Y component of FHC. It's a 3-4-5 right triangle on FHC, and the y side is the 3/5 portion. We can solve for that, and we get FHC is equal to 37.5. It's a positive number, so that force must be in tension. Notice that for each of these three equations, we're able to write them in such a way that we only have one of our unknown forces in each one. That's a really nice way to be able to do method of sections, because if I make a mistake in this equation, it won't carry through to any of the other calculations. So if you can find these special locations to do some of the moments, or if you have a situation where you have only one force that has an X component, or only one unknown force that has a Y component, this is a really nice way to set up your equations and solve for your answers. All right, thanks for watching.